Good morning. I'm Dr. Mehajabeen Fatima, professor in Electronics and Communication Department in Sagar Institute of Research and Technology, Bhopal, under the banner of the SAGE Group. Today, I'm taking lab experiment of control system at the RIT MATLAB. Subject code is EC404. I'm taking experiment number 5, pole zero map for given transfer function. Aim is draw the pole zero map of a transfer function using MATLAB. The objective is to learn how to make pole zero map of LTI system of a transfer function. Theory: the pole zero map is actually plots the transfer function poles and zeros location in S-plane. The poles are denoted by X and zeros are denoted by zero. The syntax for this is PZ map and PZ equal to PZ map. Now see here, this PZ map within parentheses SYS is written here. This syntax is actually used to draw the system poles and zeros location in S-plane. This PZ map is the command, and within parenthesis write the variable used for the transfer function. So the complete syntax for plotting of pole and zero locations is PZ map within parenthesis variable of transfer function. But if we want to calculate the location of the poles and the zeros of a given transfer function, the syntax is write P comma Z within a square bracket equal to PZ map within parenthesis SYS. SYS is the variable of transfer function. This, instead of this SYS, you can write X, Y, Z, A, B, C, D, any variable you want. Now this command returns the system poles and zeros in column vectors, but the plot will not be available on the screen. The plot will be available with the help of this pzmap command. So I'm taking one example. So see here, this is the example. Plot the poles and zeros of continuous time system of following transfer function. I wrote here one transfer function. The command is written for the transfer function. How to write transfer function in MATLAB? It was already discussed in experiment number 3 and experiment number 4. So I'm writing here directly the transfer function. So SYS is taken. This is the variable taken for the transfer function. So I'm writing SYS equal to TF. TF is the command for the transfer function. And within parenthesis and within the square bracket, write the numerator polynomial coefficients and write the denominator polynomial coefficients. So this is the method of writing the transfer function, which we were already studied about this. Now see here, GS is the transfer function. It is equal to the numerator polynomial divided by denominator polynomial. So this is equal to SYS I have taken here, the variable SYS I have taken for the transfer function. So the command is P comma Z within a square bracket equal to PZ map within parenthesis SYS. That is a variable of the transfer function. Now with this command or this syntax will give the pole location in column vector and zero location in column vector. So the command is here, you can see within a square bracket P comma Z equal to PZ map within parenthesis variable of the transfer function. This command returns the location of the poles and zeros of the given transfer function. Next command is PZ map within parenthesis SYS. Now this command will return the pole zero location in S plane. This will give the plotting figure for pole and zero. So I'm taking MATLAB for calculation of all this. First, I'm writing SYS variable for the transfer function equal to transfer function, that is TF, I'm writing TF to calculate the transfer function. Within parentheses, within a square bracket, I'm writing the values of CF. I have taken 1, 1, and 5. That is the numerator polynomial coefficient. So I'm taking here 1 space 5. Now give comma and now write the coefficients of denominator polynomial, which I have considered here. See how much it is, 1 space 2 space 1. So I'm taking here 1 space 2 space 1. So this command will give the transfer function in S. So you can see here sys sys is equal to S plus 5 upon S square plus 2S plus 1. Now for this, so we can calculate the location of poles and zeros. The poles meaning means the pole is representing the root of the denominator polynomial, and zero denotes the roots of the numerator polynomial. It means what we are doing, we are calculating the roots of numerator and denominator, or you can say with the help of the commands, the location of pole and zero can be calculated. So I'm writing here the command p comma z equal to pz map within parentheses, write the variable of transfer function. I've taken here sys sys. So I'm writing and now execute this. Now you can see here the pole, location of pole is equal to -1 and -1. It means two poles are present on -1 and zero is present on -3. So with the help of this command, you can see the location of pole and zeros can be calculated. Now this location can also be plotted. So for the plotting of pole and zero, the command is pz map within parenthesis, write s y s. So I'm executing here. So you can see the figure is open, and here the pole and zero locations are plotted in S plane. This is called pole zero map. So you can see here the pole is present at -1, two poles are present here, and zero is present at -5. Zero is present at -5. So with the help of these two commands, the location of the poles can be calculated, and the pole and zero location can be plotted in pole zero map. Now I'm taking next example. Example 2. Here I wrote the system, the transfer function, and the command for calculation of pole and zero location, and for plotting of pole and zero in pole zero map. So I'm taking this example. I'm writing CLC here to clear the screen of MATLAB. So again, I'm taking SYS as the variable equal to TF to write the transfer function. How much it was? The transfer function was 4, 12. These are the coefficients of numerator polynomial. So 4 space 12 comma within a square bracket, write the coefficients of denominator. It is how much? 1, 6, 8. These are the coefficient of denominator. So I'm writing here 1 space 6 space 8. Now this will give the transfer function. Now calculate the location of poles and zeros. Command is within a square bracket p comma z equal to pz map within parenthesis sys, variable of the transfer function. Now execute this command. You can see again the pole and zero locations are calculated here. Now if I want to plot this on pole zero map, the command is simple, pz map within parenthesis write the transfer function variable. Here sys is taken, so you can see here. So the figure is drawn here. The pole is present at -2 and another pole is present at -4 and zero is present at -3. So in with the help of this pz map command, the pole and zero locations can be plotted in pole zero map. So this completes this experiment.